Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, nahmaduhu wa nasalli ala rasulihi al-kareem, amma ba'd. My dear respected and honorable brothers and elders and mothers and sisters, subhanallah, our hearts are very sad and our eyes tear because of what we've been seeing and hearing recently in regards to the explosion which happened at Lebanon in Beirut. And Allahu Akbar, it's a really, really sad thing to be able to see that so many people are now affected. Allahu Akbar. Catastrophe, wherever it happens, to whoever it happens, our heart always goes out to such individuals. As of what we've, the recent news, 137 people now have been killed and 5,000 have been wounded. And they say 300,000 people are now homeless. The catastrophe that it has caused no less than $3 billion worth of damage throughout the city. Allahu Akbar. And the explosion which took place was at a particular port on the Eastern Mediterranean, which was one of the most busiest ports of Lebanon. 60% of all imports come through that particular port. And there was a lot of grain and food that was stocked in this particular port. And it mentions 80%, 85% of the country's grain has now been wiped off. And now, after a month, the country may not have enough grain after another month. So this is a very, very massive humanitarian crisis now which has struck Lebanon. And subhanAllah, we make dua, Allah Ta'ala make it easy for all of the people. But the sad reality is that this has been going on for quite some time. Recently, there was protests, last year protests. From June 2019 onward, there've been inflation happening approximately sometimes up to 20% a month. Yani, in simple words, what was costing you in 1 month, next month it will cost you 20% more, and then the next month 20% more, and then the next month 20% more, and like that, keep on rising. It mentions that what was costing in 2019, in 2020 June, things have been doubled. So the living standard has gone double as expensive. To give you an example, if a person was earning, say, 750,000 Lebanese pounds last year, which would have been equivalent to about $500, that same now, $75 to $80 now. You can see the massive difference between 75 and 500, how much, subhanAllah, the people must be feeling it. But there's been this constant issue now for quite some time. Unfortunately, there was a lot of protests last year because of reports of or allegations of corruption and mismanagement by the political elite. And then with Lebanon had those issues. And then December, there were massive, I mean, really severe downpour, torrential downpour, which as a result, there was many of the country was affected, but specifically Beirut as well. A lot of parts were flooded because of the inadequate sewage system. And as a result, there were floods everywhere. Toppled with that, in addition to that, you also have the COVID issue. It's where many months people have not been able to work. So a lot of people's livelihoods are also there. And then to add to that, then there is this recent issue now. Now, we don't know exactly the ins and outs, who's responsible, what happened, what are the inner stories, and so on and so forth. The truth is, Allah knows best at this moment. Things may come out. If they do come out, then we'll talk about it then. I want to talk about this purely from an Islamic point of view as to, can we learn a lesson from such things? Is there a lesson that can we learn? What can we take from this as something positive? Because Muslims, when they lost in the Battle of Uhud, they still went back and they fought, got stronger and came back even better. So Muslims are people that take ibrah, lesson from things. We're not people who just sit down with a defeatist mentality. We bounce back, and we bounce back harder and stronger. But the thing is that what I want to share with you is a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Sahih Muslim, hadith number 1955, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentioned there's a part of a hadith, inna allaha kataba al-ihsana ala kulli shay. Allah Ta'ala has prescribed goodness in everything. Ulama, what do they mention in this particular hadith? What does this mean? Ihsan means to do something with perfection, to do something with itqan, to do something properly, to do something with kamal and perfection. That is what is meant from this particular hadith, that when you do something, whoever you are, in whichever way, shape or form, whichever level you are, whether you are a servant, whether you are working in a company, whether you are a governor of a country, whether you're the prime minister, our job is to do the best thing, the right thing, and the best of what we're able to do, at any given moment in time. And this is what the Sharia demands of us, that in all of the things which are permissible in the deen, we do those things which are best. We do the things which are best for the people, best for the economy, best for the individuals, best for the ra'iyah, and so on and so forth. And this is my issue, wallahi, that we've had for such a long time. We see this rife across so many Muslim countries. Let me hasten to add, this is not just limited to Muslim countries. Non-Muslim countries, they are there as well. But why am I specifically addressing the Muslim countries? It's because we are supposed to be those individuals, the flag bearers of Islam, the people who claim to be on haqq, the people who say we've got the Quran and Sunnah, we've got the best way of life, but we don't portray that best way of life. Because we're doing backdoor, we're doing corruption, we're doing mismanagement, we're doing issues on the side. Subhanallah, according to one report, the Lebanese customs officials had sent 6 letters over 3 years to the government to explain to them that, look, this is a catastrophe in the waiting. Now the Lebanese officials are now at beef with each other. Now the blame game is starting. Who's responsible for what and so on. The blaming of the officials is now happening. Who's now going to take the blame? Because of the complacency, because of the susti and the laziness of a couple of individuals. Now, as I mentioned, based on the report which we've got, otherwise the truth is only Allah knows best. But let's just suppose there was, for example, as some people are claiming in some sources, that it was an outside thing. Well, has not the country even got this much aqal to protect their ports? Have we lost the plot? Have we lost our brains? Where is the security for the people? Something that was as significant as that. Where was the security for the people? Where was the security for the port? So we can slice this any way we want, and we can say this is responsible or they're responsible. The truth is, we don't know at this moment in time. And I'm not one of these people that just falls into any sort of news just based on some conspiracy. We're looking at the facts at this moment, and what it's saying is not very healthy. The fact that 2,750 tons of chemical was sitting in a port, and no one did nothing to move that. Highly explosive chemicals. And in near a residential area as well. Ittaqullah, wallahi, fear Allah. Those hukumran, those governors, those individuals, whoever is responsible, you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because you've got the blood on your hands of the people. And as a result, the humanitarian crisis which is about to unfold is going to get even worse. And there is a khatr and a danger that now, because of that, even hyperinflation may occur, where 50% price rises every single month. May Allah Ta'ala let it not happen, that may Allah make it where that does not happen. Ameen. Ya Allah, keep the people safe from ever that happening in there or any country. Venezuela also suffered that. Our hearts went out to Venezuela as well. We don't want bad for any individual. A Muslim is that individual that wants khair and good for everybody. But we also want the khair for these individuals as well. And this is their hour of need. As Muslims, we can make dua for them, we can pray for them. But also where the opportunity arises, we should also help by finances as well in the best possible way we can. I want to finish off here. I want this to serve as a small... We have to take reminders from things. We have to learn. We're not people that just to sit and pull our hair and think, okay, well, the job is done. What can we learn from this? What we learn from this is we need to fix up and come back onto the deen. Had we been making amal on deen and looked at it as a responsibility, wallahi ladheem, this may or perhaps would not have occurred. May Allah Ta'ala guide us all, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.